she bad, Michael Jack, I'ma let her know. And if she do how she say, then I can't let her go. Oh, I can't let her go. I can't let her go. I can't let her go. I can't let her go.
What's going on, guys? DoomGuy1516. Today I'll be showing you how to pull HQ door glass out of the door. It's actually pretty complicated, so as you can see here, from the last time you've seen it, it's now missing a door. So I've just spent about half an hour to 45 minutes pulling the door off and taking the glass out. So there's the glass, and then there's all the actuators. So glass usually sits in here. Took it out, and so today it's basically just showing you how to do that and like how I did it. So to do that, what we need to do, we'll do it on this side as soon as that door's already done. We'll go to this side. So I'll do a little bit of a time lapse so you don't have to watch me pull the door off, but I'll just show you how I pull the door off quickly. Alright, so to pull the door off, it's basically just three bolts on the hinges, three more down there. You can either pull it off the cab, or you can pull it off the door. I choose to pull it off the door because the door's heavy, but you can do it whichever way, it doesn't really matter. So I'll do a quick time lapse of that, and I'll show you how to pull the glass out.
Yeah, I love it, hey, still love it.
Alrighty guys, now the door's off, now we can pull the glass out. So I'll pull the hinges off a little later, so I'll find an A-frame, a spare A-frame that I have for this one, or I might just take the door off that one and lay it on the tray maybe, but I'll figure something out, but I'll just figure this out and I'll be right back.
A few inches later.
Alright, so now the door's on the A-frame. So now we gotta get to everything. So all of this sound deadener, gotta go. So I'll do a quick time lapse of that, pull all that off, and then I promise I'll show you how to pull it out. Alright, so that's done. Now we can see in here. Alright, so what we need for this job, a torch, if I can grab the screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, and what I didn't bring back from over here, is it over here? Yep. Is a ratchet and some sockets. So the socket size that we'll need is a 9/16, but currently what I've got on here is a 1/2 inch because I just did the doors, so pull that off, come up here, and get my 9/16, pull this back up, put it on here. Alright, so the bolts that you want to undo is this one, don't touch those three, but this one right here, if I can point at it, it's so hard like pointing the camera at it. This one here, usually there's two, but that one's obviously missing, and I don't know why. And then you got this one here buried under the sockets. And that should be all of the bolts, but then on this side, there's a screw right there and right there. You'll need to take those two out as they hold the brackets for the door holder. So in the door part through here, there's rubber that's usually there, but the rubber that was in this is all gone and it's all rotted out, and so what it's all rubber all the way down here. So that's what's holding that. Those two screws are holding the bracket on, which holds the rubber. So we'll take this out now, and if I'll just put everything down. put the torch here. We'll take this out. So that one. That one. This probably isn't very good video quality for you, so I'll stand on. And set you up here just for a minute. So we'll undo this one. Oh, fell out. My mistake. Go there. And then this one in this little cove. Please don't fall over. Please. Thank you. Thank you. This one. And then the last one is right here. So we'll take those out. And alright, so I've got those bolts out. Now we need to get the screws out. And I'll just move this ladder. Alright, so we'll get the screws out. So we'll get the screwdriver. Whoa. It's so hard doing this with the camera, I'm really sorry, but yeah. So undo that one. Undo that one. I have a bench behind me, so I think. And no, you can't see. I think that's. I think that's right. So. If it falls, my iPad's gonna shatter. Alright, so we'll take these off. This is my first time actually taking glass out of a door. So the first one I did it was the one over there. And I've basically just learned this all by myself. And what you need to do when you take the screws out, make sure you have somewhere to put all of them. So this is the container that I'm using for now. I have many containers. So I'll put them in there. And never lose a bolt, because when you go to put it back all together, and you don't have the bolts, then you're kind of like a little bit screwed. So now the next thing you want to do is you come over here, and this thing right here, there is a screw right there. So you want to take that one out. Then after that, these arms right here, they're in like little folding arms. Yep, can see that. So what you want to do, you basically want to like pull it together like that, so it comes out of these ends. So do it with both of them, and then that should all pull out as soon as the bolts are no longer in there, since I just took them out. So I'll do that quickly. My arm just cut out for a second there. All right. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do this, but I'll set that up there. Hopefully you guys can see that and the iPad won't fall over. So basically you just got to like toggle it and then hope that you don't scratch the glass. So you got to be really careful that when you're taking this out, you don't like accidentally drop it on the glass, because that'll scratch it, and it's currently caught on something. There we go. So now this is out, so we're going to put this down somewhere here, and my other ones are there. So now what we'll do is, now that that's out, we can take that little screw out, which I've done this a couple of times because I've been trying to like figure it out for a while. Sorry if the camera's a bit jumpy, it's just really hard doing this with, like, one hand. So, as I said before, never lose anything you take out. Always have something to put your nuts and bolts and screws in. I learnt that the hard way. I was pulling a wagon apart that I had to put back together, and I just put all of the nuts and bolts and screws in the container, and then I kicked the container over. And I thought, nah, she'll be right. And then I ended up losing about 12 nuts and bolts that I desperately needed to put the guards on. Which I probably shouldn't be showing you that, because there's no guard on that. But no harm done. Alright, So now we come around here, and this goes all the way down here. So it's actually behind this plate. And what you got to do is, there's usually rubber in it, but because this one's like ruined and it's just gotten old over time, it's not in there. So they should be easy to pull out, seeing as all the screws have been pulled out. So again, I'll set it up. There. This is probably really bad, but I'm pretty sure there might have been something else. I'm not quite sure. Oh no, I've just got to pull the glass off, but leave it in there. So what I'll do is I'll try and like pull it so it's out, and I'll get that out just so you're not blinded. Go around the other way. It's very limited space in the shed just because of how small it is. I'll move there. Please don't fall. I should be able to pull the glass out right now. Yes. No. Yes. Alright, and then there's the glass out, but what we have to do now is get those inner rubbers out, because if you don't, they'll fall out and you'll lose them. So I'll just put the glass down. Alright, so you got to make sure that you have it somewhere it's not going to be affected or like smashed. Throw that over there. Place this ever so slightly right here. And now we can focus on getting these out. So this should, that one's a pain in the ass, but this one right here, as you can you can see it in there. See, it's out. So, hey buddy. Buddy, say hi. He's a little shy. Alright, so we'll grab this out. And so this is what I was talking about. These sit in here. And that bit right there is where the screw goes on that side. And basically, as you wind the window up and down, the window sits in this so that it doesn't like move around, and it's got the rubber in it so that obviously it doesn't like smash or chip or crack or anything. And it's the same on that side. So now, the guys that had it before me, they did like a poor poo job, and a body filler job, I should say. And oh, there we go. Alright, so what I did there was I reached in here to the actual actuator thingy madoobie here, and I basically just yanked it out just because it's old, it's stuck, and they like glued it in, and that's not very good. So we'll put these down, put them with that so we know which side they came out of. And so there we go, we have the HQ door glass out, and now the door is glassless, which probably isn't a word, but it is now because I said it. And yeah, so now what I'm going to do is, if you've seen the past couple of videos, if not, I'll link the playlist to my one tunner from my channel on here, and I'm repainting my ute, so I'm nearly there. It's all stripped down now, and if you come around here, here are my guards. I've just painted them, so I've primed them and I've prepped them. And then my bonnet here, I just spent about 12 hours rubbing it down nice and smooth, gave it a buff, turned up really shiny. It like doesn't come up on camera, which is really annoying when you want to show someone something and you obviously can't see it now because it's wet. And yeah, from all of the rain we've just had, my yard is a mess, and it is flooded. So yeah, that's that. So if we come back in here, there's the ute, and then there's my wall of fame. The two inner guards on the left there, they aren't out of this. Those ones on the tray are out of this, so they're done. They're right to go back on. Their spares, the inner doors, the door skins, they're mine. They're off this ute. Hubcaps, that I got them from this ute. Back window, that's from here. Nose cone on the wall, that's not mine. I got, that's a spare one. That one over there is mine. The radiator support down there is mine. That one is a spare. And here's all of the extra parts and stainless behind. And yeah, oh, hey look, buddy. Hey buddy, what are you doing? All right, so that concludes pulling HQ door glass out of a HQ door. No matter how many times I would like Google it or YouTube how to pull HQ door glass out, like none would come up. And I would only get like how to do Jeeps and how to do Land Rovers and doors with basically just electric windows. And it was so annoying, I couldn't find it. So I spent, before I like recorded this one, I spent about an hour trying to figure out how to pull the door glass out of this one. And then it made it pretty easy for this one because I knew what I was doing. So I thought I'd video it because I've never seen a video of how to pull HQ door glass out of a door. And it's so annoying when you're trying to do something like what I'm doing, painting a car, when you need to get it done, you need to try and get it done as quick as you can because it's winter time. And when you're painting, it has to be 16 degrees or above. If it's not, your paint won't dry, it'll just run. And it ends up a waste of paint, waste of money, waste of time. And you basically have to sand it all back or wipe it off if it's still wet. And it just takes too much time. So I'm just trying to get everything done as quick as I can before winter. But what I'm doing here is I'm going to pull the engine out. I'm going to repaint the engine because it is quite faded down there. And it is quite flaky right there. And it doesn't look very nice. So I'm going to pull the engine out, and while that's out, I'm going to repaint the firewall, and I'm going to paint all of this so it is nice and black. And hi buddy. Then, oh, as you can see, my custom battery holder, which is pristinely held on by zip ties. Yeah, so that's basically, oh, and from the last video, I don't know if I showed you this, but I've pulled my dash out, and it's actually easier than I thought. That's done. I'd like to thank you so much for watching my videos. Make sure to like and subscribe. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Have a look through the playlist that I've made of my one tonner, which will be linked in the description and on a card at the end of this video. And just check out the rest of my videos. I play Doom on the Xbox. I don't go on the Xbox much anymore mainly because I've got this to do now and I don't have like much time available to like waste on the Xbox. And when I get on my Xbox, I get a bit like weird. But anyway, thank you so much for watching my videos. Make sure to like and subscribe. Comment down below what you think about this car, what you think I should do with it. And yeah, so catch you in the next video.